had a force on the shaft, and then it tends to break. Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries, and in this time I want to show you splitting up the wood that I have. It's already there, some part that I still need to move to my shed. Some things I want to show you. I like to split up the wood myself using a manual axe. Of course it's always easier to use a splitting machine, but instead of watching YouTube videos all day, it's also sometimes good to do some workout, so I like to split up my wood by hand. I had a lot of axes in the past. I broke a lot of wooden shafts, and when I saw this one I was really happy about it, because as you can see, already have it for quite some time, used it a lot, and it's still not broken, because sometimes you smash and part of the wood is really soft, so you go into it and then the edge is really hard, and then you get quite a force on the shaft, and then it tends to break. And with a plastic one, you really don't have a problem at all. So something I really could advise. Another thing that I like to advise is, when you have a really thick part, it's always good to use a splitter. Now, this is an aluminum splitter, this is a steel one. They both work well for splitting up some really thick material that is very hard to split. In many cases, it's not even the thickness that is really worrying. It is when you have some cross parts in the wood, then sometimes it's very hard to split it. And then those two guys really help to get through it. I will show you. Another advice I like to give is to use an old tire. I read that in a book on people from Scandinavia, from Finland to be exactly, and they use an old tire. They put in the parts that they want to split. It's also easy, because this way the wood tends to keep standing up, and when you hit the sides, it doesn't really matter, because it's soft. So it's really good advice. Let's split some wood and let me show you. So as you can see, the wood is totally split up in a few seconds, and it's kept together nicely because of the tire. And it also helps to damp the axe when you miss it. So we're at the tip somewhere in the book, and I think it's a nice tip from a Finnish forester. So I do like always to take it up immediately and bring it away. Sometimes you can do that, and then it's a pile like that over there. So let's bring in the cavalry then. Thank you. Well, as they always say, burning wood makes you warm a couple of times. Well, this is a clear example. This part is really from the root. Well, the other parts are also, which always makes it very difficult, of course, to split. But even with those guys, even that can be done. But yeah, it's quite some work, but it keeps you fit. So now you saw the splitting axe in use. I also brought the cutting axe, and you can really see the difference. Where the splitting axe really is designed to go in and push the wood aside to really split it apart, the cutting axe is much more thin and really designed to cut deep into the wood without creating too much resistance. So this is a clear difference between the two. I both have them now in plastic shafts, which I really like because they really don't break, and also they really damp the vibration when you hit the wood. Another advantage is that on the backside you can use that to hit the splitting wedges into the wood and use it as a hammer. So here you see some examples of splitting wedges. This is a very standard one. Steel, and these two are a little bit different in the sense that when you look very carefully they are a little bit turned, a little bit rotated. So what happens is when this one goes in, it goes into the wood, but because of the turned effect, the rotated effect, it will really split the wood going in. It will be more effective in splitting than the other one. And this is the same type of idea, but then a steel version. And as I showed you, they really work well in splitting parts that are really having cross connections, because that's the thing. A big log, the thickness doesn't really matter because you start from the edge and you go in. So it doesn't really matter whether it's thick. The things that are a little bit different to split is when they have cross connections. Like the root part of the wood that I showed you to split, that's a really difficult one because they have all types of cross connections, and as a result they won't go apart very easily. So you see, with a little bit of help from a splitting wedge, even that is possible. Here's a nice example of how I store my wood. So I put them all in large piles like this. This vertical beam I can easily take away or hang it up over here, which makes it quite easy to put new wood in and to take old one out. It's quite a good clamped in between, so that makes it a strong construction. Here you can see the large piece of wood that I use to split the wood with the axe, with the tire as I showed you. So that that works really nice. In order to measure the moisture level of the wood, you can use these measurement devices. They all work with the same principle. Two pins on the top. This one is a general one, and this one is one from steel. Also two pins. And by putting it in the wood, you can really measure what the resistance value is. And since the resistance value of wood is a direct function of the moisture level, it tells you what the moisture level is. This one you can even select what type of wood it is to make it more accurate. The steel one is very simple, you just put it in and there's no change in type of wood. Because of the size and the very nice working principle, I still prefer the steel one, to be honest. When you take a general piece of wood that is lying on the outside, you can measure it. So you can put it in. It now says 18%. 13% like this, and when you do it on the side, 14%. The other side, 17%. But that doesn't say a lot because that's on the outside of the wood. To do proper measurement, you really have to cut it and see what it is, what the value is on the inside of the wood. So let's do that. So this is the freshly cut side. Now when I do a measurement on the freshly cut size, I do a good measurement because that was on the inside of the wood. Putting it on, it says now 0%, putting it in, it says now 13%. So this is nice for putting in the fire.